In this series of videos, I'm going to walk through class variance authority, or CVA, and how you can use it with something like Tailwind or really any kind of CSS classes to create a set of components. So in this example, we're going to be making some button components, but really the principles extend to any components you want to build. I think CVA is a very cool, tiny library with a really small footprint. One little word of warning is that CVA 1.0 is coming out pretty soon. There'll be minor updates. The most noticeable of one is we'll be going from class variance authority as like the actual NPM name to CVA, which is kind of nice. So just make note of that. This might be out of date by the time you are seeing this video. If you want to code along though, you can go to the repo that I have and just make sure that you are on the start branch and not the main branch. The start is going to be at the kind of start of everything. It's going to have a bunch of stuff with like to-dos and everything will be filled out. But if you just want to see the end results of what I have, you can go to the main branch. With that being said, let's dive into the code. So here we have a bunch of buttons. And like I said, we're using Tailwind to style it. You don't have to use Tailwind. That's just what we're using because it works well. It works well specifically with CVA. So we have a bunch of buttons. We have these secondary buttons and these primary buttons. And it's really just a bunch of copying and pasting of a bunch of different styles to create all this kind of stuff. So that's not really great for a component library. With a button component, we'd want to be able to pass in some higher level properties like, you know, intent and size and some things like that, and just have the button itself figure out what the actual class name should be so that it is styled correctly. So without something like CVA, class variance authority, this might look like doing function button, and then you're going to return, of course, your button, and you'll render your children. So those come from your props, right? And then here you're going to have your class name, right? So you'd have your class name, and it might look something along the lines of like, okay, well, we have an intent, and we were going to say if the intent is something like, I don't know, primary. So where's this intent coming from? Well, it's going to be another prop. So if it's primary, then we, you know, we want it to say like BG indigo, like 600 or whatever it is. But then if the intent is secondary, you know, it's going to be maybe a background of white. And so you're basically going to be kind of doing all this logic with a bunch of ternaries, maybe something like CLSX or class names, like a little library like that, that'll kind of smoosh them all together. And that might work for a little while, but in my opinion, something like CVA just makes this a lot easier and just a lot cleaner, as well as offering a little bit of type safety as you build it out. So we're going to move this up here. We will eventually build on top of this, but for now, we're just going to comment that out and we're going to pull in CVA and start playing with it. So at the very top, we're going to import from class variance authority. And again, this will change to CVA. Seems like they got the NPM name for that. So that's pretty cool. And we will import CVA from it. So what is CVA? If we just hover over it, we can see that it takes a base of a class value. So it's like a string basically, and then some sort of configuration. And then on the right-hand side, you can see that it returns a function, which takes some props to be defined essentially by that T. And that will return some strings. So it's a factory function. It's a function that's going to create a function. So yeah, that's pretty much how CVA works. And it's a little bit easier to see in practice. So let's go down here and we're going to create something called button variance. And that'll be CVA. And so like I said, with this is basically the base string or the base like classes that we want applied to all versions of the button. Looking just at this, we may not necessarily know immediately what those kind of class names are, but if we scroll down, we can start getting a feel. If we just start highlighting stuff, we can see what is the same across all of them. So we can see so far, nothing is actually the same across all of them. Like rounded is only true for the small or the extra small and the small, but then later on it's rounded medium. Okay, they do all have BG indigo 600, but the background is going to be white for the secondary. So that's more of a like a variant thing. So we'll get to that in a second. The text small, that actually does seem to be almost the same with everything, except the text extra small at the beginning. So that doesn't work. What about this font semi bold? Well, there we go. We have a winner. So font semi bold actually is true across all of them. So that might be our only kind of basic, like this is true for everything class name. So we're just going to start with that. So let's see if there's anything else. This text white, I know the text will change. We can see even the hover state will change, and the focus, which is what kind of comes later on, is slightly different between the two of them. I think the only other thing is the shadow small is actually true across all of them. And this may not even be true for your components, but just for the case that we have, all of them only have a shadow small for all the buttons. So we'll add that as the basic thing as well. So every single, you know, variant is always just going to have a font semi bold and then a shadow small. And all the other classes are going to be really dependent on the kind of variant props that we pass in. This is where the config comes in handy, the second argument that we have. We can pass into it a variance, which will be an object. And here we get to just start making up stuff. We get to start making up what the type of variance we have. So I've said intent a couple times. I think that's one that we're going to have. And these will be objects. And then we'll have size, we know, is another one. So left to right, we can see there's like an extra small, small, medium, large, extra large. There's five size left to right. And then these columns, at least with these first three rows, they kind of show variance. So you have, or rather that first row is primary, second row we're going to call secondary, and then that third row is like a soft. So let's just code that in. So we'll say primary. And then for now, we'll fill this in later, but this is basically when we are in a primary variant, we'll have the class names that we want there, but we'll fill those in a second, like I said, secondary. And finally, I said soft, and we'll get to the sizes in a little bit. So let's look at what we have. So like I said, there was the BG Indigo 600 that seems true for the primary case. So we're gonna add that first of all. And then what else is true? Well, this PX, PY, it's the padding. That's not true. That's not the same rather across all of them. That's a size thing, same with text. We already did the font semi-bold. There we go, text white. That's certainly true for primary. It is text white, and it's definitely not text white for either of the other two. So that is specific to the variant or to the intent. And then we have the hover state. So we'll take all of this stuff and we'll just say all the hovering and focus stuff seems pretty dependent on the variant or the intent that we're on, but not really dependent on the size that we're on. Perfect. So that's the primary. Let's take the secondary. It's going to be pretty similar. And this time I'm actually just going to copy everything and then kind of remove what doesn't make sense. We'll start seeing sort of a pattern as we go. So we've got the background, but again, we get rid of all this extra stuff, and then we have the text, and then that shadow has already been accounted for. And then in this case, it does have a ring inset, and that's how we get that nice border. So it's not actually a border, it's a ring. Okay, so that looks good. And then finally, with the soft, we're gonna go all the way down here. And like I said, we'll just copy everything and remove what we don't want. And so we'll add it all, and we can see the rounded doesn't make any sense. The padding that's going to come later, the text, semi-bold, all that stuff goes away. We do want this text, of course, and we don't need the shadow. And then we just have the hover being BG Indigo 100. Okay, cool. So we have all our classes for the different variants. And so far, this has all been very kind of like hypothetical, I guess. We haven't actually seen what does this all mean? Is this, you know, how do you apply this and whatnot? So that's where we want to start implementing this. So we're going to continue building out this button that we had, but we're going to use the button variants themselves, this little function that we created. So I'll uncomment this, but instead of this class name, I'm going to get rid of all of this. I'm actually going to pull off class name here as well. And the first thing we're noticing is like we're in TypeScript and we don't actually have anything typed, so that's kind of a problem. So let's add button props. There we go. And here we'll define it above. So button props, and it's going to be react.html button. Oh man, I always mess this up. I think it's attribute button. Maybe it's not that, it's button. There we go. I pretty much always have to look this up or just kind of muck around with it until I get it. So that's just the React types for you. And here we'll pass in HTML button element. And that should give us pretty much all of the button props that we could imagine. We can see that we do have children and we have class name. And then if we just open up and see everything else, we have basically anything you could pass into a button, which is pretty cool. So what we're going to do with that is we're just going to spread, say, hey, let's get all those props and whatever else you have. You can just spread it along. This super button is really just kind of a wrapper around this button with some stylings, at least at this point. So we'll pass the class name for now. That intent, we're not getting that yet. So what we're going to do is we're going to add an intent. We'll say primary, right, secondary, and then soft was the third one. And so there we're saying, okay, the intent can be one of these three, which is good. So we can pass that along. Okay, so instead of just passing class names, we're going to pass in button variants. And the way button variants works, its API is pretty simple. So it takes in some props, and the props are like basically four things. So we can see class and class name. Those are really the same. The reason they have the class name is just for us React folks. We're kind of used to that class name as a prop, so we're going to use that. And so this is saying like any extra class names passed in, I'm gonna go ahead and merge those in. So you can basically extend this if you want. We could get rid of this. Maybe you don't want your component to have that, but for our cases, we'll allow you to just pass in arbitrary class names. And then those other two were, if you go back, you can see intent and size, which we declared and defined. So primary, secondary, soft, and it could be null or undefined. So we have the class name, and then of course we will add intent. Okay, let's go ahead and render an example of this to make sure this is working. So say button, what does it say? Button text, and we do have to pass an intent. We'll say it's primary. Cool, so we can see our button. It's not rounded, it's not quite right. The padding's all messed up because we haven't implemented all that, but we can see that it is actually working. And if we passed secondary or soft, we're getting the stuff that we want, which is really cool. So this is kind of the value of class variance authority, is we can kind of have these variants all set up and a little bit type safe. One thing I don't love here though is I hard-coded this, which is kind of annoying because I already hard-coded it here, and now I have these two things that I have to keep in sync. I'd rather just infer what the values are from here, and that's actually pretty easy to do. So in CVA, you can pull off a util type called variant props. And so if you take that variant props, and you do type of button variants. And then if I pull off the intent, you can see that now the intent is gonna be primary, secondary, soft, or null, or undefined. I personally don't super love that, so I actually created a required variant props util, and you can go look at what that is. It's just some TypeScript stuff. We're not gonna really go into it because that's not really the purpose of this specific video, but you can now see that the intent has to be primary, secondary, or soft. I'm actually gonna pull this out above and say type button variants will just equal the whole of this, but without taking out the intent specifically. So these button variants are now, you know, get intent and size, which we'll fill out. And instead of declaring each of them kind of individually, we'll just pass the whole thing along. The other thing I'm going to do is I'm actually going to make this a partial, and I'm going to make these optional. The reason I'm doing that is because I want to have some good defaults, and CVA actually makes this really easy to do. So in our config, another argument that we can add is default variance. So default variance, this will already be typed, so we can have intent, and it'll say, I mean, it's giving us all the tailwind stuff because tailwind is trying to be helpful, but really the only types are primary, secondary, you know, soft, and you'll see those. And then the size we don't have yet, so I'll add a default there. So I just want that default to be primary in this case, just so that if this were missing, the default would be primary. Cool, there we go. So we got our type set up. We got our kind of basic function or our basic button set up, which is good. And now we want to kind of finish building out the size aspect of these variants. So we scroll back down and we're gonna add our sizes. So the sizes we'll have, I've kind of alluded to it several times, we'll have a extra small, small, medium, large, and then finally extra large. Cool, so those are the variants that we want. And well, what should we add? Well, we can see that rounded is going to be true for extra small and small. And then it's rounded medium for the other three. So that's nice. And so we can actually see this changing. I'm gonna go ahead and start rendering basically every example of these. Also, now that I have some defaults here, I'm gonna do the size default to be medium. So there you go, we can see it change. I could change it to small and that would be rounded slightly less. That's about all you can see is the difference now. So back to medium, and here let's start just like rendering these rows like we did below, but we're gonna do it a little bit more programmatically. Also, I can delete this. So the first thing we wanna do is we want to create a const called intents, and this will be an array of stuff, and we can again use TypeScript to kind of help guide us here and make sure everything's good. So we're gonna use the satisfies operator, didn't mean to be capitalized. And this is kind of a newish TypeScript operator, and it's really nice because you can basically just say like, hey, here's kind of the form this thing should sort of like conform to, yet it still kind of acts as if you're doing as const. There's lots of great resources about how this works. And in this case, we're gonna take those button variants that we created below, and here we're going to get the intent, and we wanna make it an array of the intent. So now as we're writing this out, we can see that we have the type safety, which is nice, and the suggestions. So we want primary, secondary, soft. We're gonna do the same thing with the sizes. So in this case, this will be sizes. And over here, this will be size. And then over here, we can see TypeScript has already gotten ahead of us and said, what are you doing? These are not sizes. We didn't give these to you. So you got extra small, small, medium, large, and XL. Cool, so we got our sizes, we got our intents. All right, so I'm gonna map over these. So I'll say intents.map, intent. And then we're going to actually render a button wrapper first. We need to add our key so that React doesn't get mad at us. So we got our button wrapper, and then inside of here, we want to render the sizes, and we're gonna map each of those, and we'll do a size. And then in there, we can actually, let's just copy what we have currently. And we'll render that. What will the key be? It will be size here. And then of course, we want to add our intent as intent and size as size.
Cool.
So now we have our kind of rows of buttons that we wanted, but we actually would like them to look nice or look correct, but now they're at least rendered. So this will be a little bit easier to make sure we're doing everything correctly. Going back down here, we can see, okay, what are all the differences between smalls, mediums, larges, etc. So the first thing we're going to take is we want the PX and PY, the padding. So we're going to take that, and it's the same for the extra small and the small. So that's easy, but we'll just copy it across. That's all good. It's okay if two variants have kind of similarities in there. The next one's got a little bit different. So we'll add that here. And then we got this one. And then finally, this last one for the extra large. So now if we save this, let's see what happens on the left side. Okay, those all look the exact same. So something has clearly gone wrong. And what's gone wrong is we actually don't have the size being forwarded to the button variants. So now if we change that, we can actually see it's a little bit more correct. I can tell that one thing is wrong. It's the text is not quite right. So that it should be text extra small for the extra small case. And then just it's text small for all four of the others. So again, we'll just copy and paste that. It's okay to have a little bit of copy and paste because at least everything is like specific to the variant types that we have here. So that's cool. So we got our text extra small, we got our padding, which is really good. We got our rounded state, the font semi bold, the text color, the hover state, the shadow. I think everything on here is really good. We can even, you know, tap through these and these all look correct, which is really great. That's pretty much the power of class variance authority. It's pretty simple and it gives you all this type safety and it's super cool. Of course, we're definitely not quite done. We have a bunch of other buttons. We have buttons with icons and we have rounded buttons and we have icon specific buttons. So we're going to keep moving forward with creating all those in the next video.